Good afternoon, my name is Stefano Cattini and I will present the research activity carried out during my last year in the field of... Sorry. As stated before, in the field of optoelectronic instrumentation and measurement for biomedical science, my main research activities are focused on the development of a system able to identify motion scatters in ocular fundus, thus in order to analyze temperature and choroidal blood flow perfusion. After the introduction of the research question, I will give some insight into photon correlation spectroscopy. So I introduce the theoretical model and the designed and developed the experimental setup. Then I will report and discuss one of the experimental results. We are studying light propagation in ocular fundus because we would like to develop an instrument able to identify physiological parameters such as fundus temperature and choroidal blood flow perfusion. Thus, a possible application is the identification of a convenient endpoint in transpupillary thermotherapy. TTT is known to be an effective treatment for several ocular diseases, but up to now, a few studies have been carried out in order to determine a suitable endpoint, thus leading to several under- or overexposure. Signs under- and overexposure produce an effective treatment or local blinding. This constitutes a substantial limitation in the TTT diffusion. As stated before, we would like to analyze blood flow and the temperature exploiting photon correlation spectroscopy. In order to give an insight into the technique, suppose to radiate the sample with a steady optical intensity and to analyze the scattering and back diffuse at optical intensity. That is, suppose to radiate the sample with X photon in each time interval and to count the detective photon in the relative time interval. So, if all the scatters are motionless, each set of X photon will give rise to the same number of detected photon. On the contrary, if the scatters could move, each set of X photon could encounter a different scatters arrangement, thus giving rise to a different detected photon number. As a result, the ratio of variation of the detected photon number, that is its autocorrelation function, could give information about the ratio of variation in the scatters arrangement. Or, in other words, from the autocorrelation function, it's possible to retrieve information about the dynamics of the scatters. Signs in ocular fundus. The scatters motion is mainly due to blood flow and thermal vibration. From the measured autocorrelation function, it's possible to retrieve the desired information. Obviously, in order to retrieve such information, a theoretical model is required. Also, the development of a theoretical model able to describe light propagation in ocular fundus is not a trivial problem. For timing reason, I will present only the theoretical model developed in order to describe the scatter's motion. Scattering in ocular fundus is caused by a mixture of macrostructure and molecules. Some of the structures could move, whereas others are fixed. So, in order to describe the mean square displacement, we exploit random flow model for describing the red blood cell motion, whereas we exploiting harmonically bounded Brownian particle model for describing retinal and choroidal scatters mobility. It's important to notice that from Wu square is possible to retrieve information about the blood flow, whereas from delta and tau, it's possible to retrieve information about the temperature. In order to acquire the desired autocorrelation function, we have realized the setup reported in the pictures. The TTT treatment was performed exploiting a therapeutic laser diode represented by the yellow beam. In order to the analysis of the ocular fundus were performed exploited a modified ophthalmic microscope. A 70-30 beam splitter coupled the probe beam and collect the backscattered light. The probe beam was provided by a helium laser focused into a single mode fiber. The subobtained beam was aligned to the optical of the microscope and focused onto the treatment region. The back diffused light was collected by a second single mode fiber. The so collected photons were processed by means of single photon counting module, and the electric signal from the SPCM was processed by a digital correlator. The so obtained autocorrelation function have been processed by means of an ad hoc MATLAB script. As stated before, from the value of V square is possible to retrieve information about the flow dynamics, whereas from delta and tau, it's possible to retrieve information about the temperature. The reported data are relative to a low-power TTT treatment. Moreover, before and after the treatment, we acquire free measure. As expected and as reported by other authors, the temperature increases. In fact, our show, as shown by the data, the delta and tau value increase, thus pointing out the expected thermal increasing. Regarding V-square, choroidal thermal-induced vasodynamic is known to be a complex mechanism. Some research report an flow increase aimed to remove the exceeding thermal energy. However, a recent human study report a flow reduction caused by vasorestriction. Our measure agree with both this phenomena after an initial increase in the V square value, which agree with the flow increase aimed to thermal removal. We have a subsequent decrease in the V square value, probably due to the vascular restriction, to the thermal induced vascular restriction. Concluding, the system is able to identify variation in temperature and choroidal blood perfusion. Thus, its potential use is the identification of a convenient endpoint for transpupillary thermotherapy. As future work, we are now developing a Phantom and a Monte Carlo simulation aimed to overcome the experimental artifacts typically related to in vivo measurement. Moreover, we believe that the integration of other wave sources could better point out the different contribute of dynamical and optical property on the acquired function. Thank you for the attention.
Question, please.